The banana, a well-known and popular treat, eaten alone, cooked with other food, enjoyed in many ways. Since its discovery in Western Africa, European power spread it to the four corners of the world, making it a household item. With the creation of the sweet yellow banana in the 1800s, the fruit has only become even more popular. It's no secret sailors of old loved fruit and ate it regularly. Vitamin C from fruit prevented the devastating disease scurvy, a disease that often had such horrific symptoms as swelling gums, convulsions, altered personalities, and causing the scar tissue of old wounds to break down. This caused long-healed wounds to separate and bleed again. Death often came, but slowly and painfully. The one known cure being eating fruit. So would it surprise you to hear that the mariner of old was afraid of bananas and figured them to be bad luck? Trade of bananas has occurred for centuries, but mariners would often dread transporting the good. Some captains downright refused. They believed the fruit to be bad luck, accounting for cargo holds of food spoiling, leaving sailors to spend weeks or even months of a crossing with no fruit. Heaven forbid a ship should lose the wind in the doldrums and be left without vitamin C from fruit, just waiting to catch scurvy. Others claim ships transporting them would wreck or be lost more often. But surely this is all silly superstition. There couldn't possibly be any science to these claims. Or is there? The fact of the matter is, bananas are indeed cursed fruit. When the banana ripens, it releases ethylene gas. This is a colorless gas with a slightly sweet smell, but most damning is the fact that it causes other fruit to ripen faster, meaning a crate of ripening bananas can cause an entire cramped cargo hold of fruit to spoil very early on in a voyage. This leaves an entire crew partway through a long journey with no fruit. Another culprit could be the creatures that seek refuge in bunches of bananas. Coming from mostly tropical regions, this leaves the banana as a home for any number of venomous snakes and spiders, who now find themselves free to roam the cramped decks of wooden ships on long sea crossings. Imagine the dread of any European sailor who wakes up to find that his hammock is now being shared with a venomous snake or a large tarantula. Lastly, bananas are buoyant, meaning if a ship should ever come across the wreckage of a sunken ship, amongst the flotsam and jetsam would be crates and bunches of bananas. After not too long, a connection might not be too hard to make. In modern times, the banana would hardly be considered a risk. Reefers on a ship in dry storage make the risk presented by bananas hardly a factor. But some modern mariners still claim the yellow fruit to be a risk. We know the causes from the age of sail to be legitimate. But is there something else at work to this very day? Something supernatural, perhaps? Probably not. But better safe than sorry. What do you think? Have you ever heard this superstition from the old salts? Do you believe in it yourself? Well, let me know by commenting below. And please, stay tuned for more superstitions with the Superstitious Sailor. Fair winds and following seas to you, shipmates.